Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101. Yeah, we gonna talk.
I know y'all, you wasn't there that night because you guys don't really move and go out and stuff. But
yeah,
just where were you at when you found out that Woody had passed over?
Bro, somebody had called me and told me such and such had shot Woody. So I had, you know what I'm saying, I hung up in his face like, hell nah, they partners. You know what I'm saying? That don't happen. And then shit, 10 minutes later, Lil Blake called me, so I knew it was serious.
Yeah.
And the hospital was literally 4 minutes away. I could have took out running to the hospital. But I grabbed my girl. I think we grabbed, was Jada with us? Yeah, we grabbed my little daughter too. She was just born. Why didn't even get to see her yet? But I grabbed my little girl, and we went to the hospital, and that's when we got the bad news.
Okay, and Lil Blake, where were you at when you found out?
I was at the crib, sleep. It's crazy because they called me at like 1 o'clock. He like, man, ain't no way Woody then went out without us. Hell nah. I'm like, it's already 1 something. I know the club closed at 2. I'm like, shit, it's too late now. We already at the crib. So he like, man, I'm going to just call you tomorrow, brother. And I just go to sleep. He just started blowing my phone up at like 3 in the morning.
Who?
3. Zay.
Okay.
One of my members, man. He just started blowing my phone up. I'm declining. I'm pissed. He keep calling. I'm like, bro, why nigga keep calling me? Not knowing I'm on FaceTime, somebody tell me to answer. It could be important. I answer. He said, damn, Ben Man just shot Woody. I said, hell nah. And I just hung up the phone. I'm like, hell nah. Hell nah, Ben Man ain't shoot Woody. Not knowing, like, I don't even know whatever was going on. Bitch, you don't shoot.
It wasn't that important.
Nah, it ain't important to all these people. Hell nah. But then it was true shit. Bad man shot Woody.
Yeah. But the one thing I can tell you is, were you about to say something?
Yep.
Go
yeah.
ahead.
They let their pride get in the way. Like, especially if that's your partner and you know y'all been rocking like that, why would you let, how are you letting him get that far? Like,
yeah.
You probably like, hey, we can't even do this right now. We talk about this later.
Hey, we get into it about everything except girls.
I heard y'all be fighting. I heard your mama tell me that.
We gonna go out there and punch.
Yeah.
Hard.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna pass him my backwoods 30 seconds later and tell him I love him. Yeah, every time. Every time. That's how it happened. Every single time. But that nigga, like, he wasn't one of us. You know what I'm saying? Like, we didn't know him from
growing
you
up.
You know what I'm saying? We didn't know him like that. You know what I'm saying? That was Woody. Like,
so Woody had met him.
Woody brought us around him. You know what I'm saying?
How did that connection happen though? Was it the Lil Jug or whatever? Was that his homeboy or something?
I mean, yeah, but I don't really want too much to talk about it, bro. You know what I'm saying? But they were cool, you know what I'm saying? They were partners. Fucked up, you know what I'm saying, how it happened, but yeah, I don't really want too much to talk about it, bro. We can talk about Woody though for sure.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Well, like I said, everything takes time, bro.
Yeah, for sure.
Time heals everything. You know that, right?
Yeah.
I know y'all right now, everybody, you know, It's intense, you know what I'm saying? When you lose a loved one, somebody that you care about, but the most important thing is you here, and you got to find a way to stay here, to stay free, to not get caught up in nothing where you gon' you. I know you got a kid, she got a kid, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
It's a bigger picture, man. You gotta think smart.
Right.
These streets is something else that eat you up and spit you out.
For sure.
You know what I'm saying? So you just gotta be. You gotta watch how you move. And niggas will come for you. This is the environment we in.
I ain't gonna lie, we done been through so much shit. It's like, we moved so right, it's like that shit had to be destined to happen.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Cause like, we don't move like, sloppy.
Yeah, that don't even sound right, like we fighting in front of everybody in front of the club. Like, what y'all got going? Like,
you know what I'm saying? If one of us was there, like, and everybody, I always say this, but I know this for a fact. If a two-fold member was there, it wouldn't happen like that, but nobody in 2-4 was there. You know what I'm saying? His brothers, his uncles and shit was there, but nobody else with him every day was there. You know what I'm saying? I feel like if I was there, I would know I would have had my car, so he would have been in my car.
Yeah.
If he was there, he would have been right behind him. Mm-hmm. So if he shot a gun, he would have got shot too.
For sure.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
no, I get it.
For sure, for shit, so I can bet my last dollar on it, and I got a whole bunch of them.
Yeah.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101.